Franco?
Yeah. I'm confused by the light.
Normally this one's less red, but they're both pretty red right now. Tunes to play,
yeah.
I'd say. It's pretty fun. It's written by our great friend Joe Walsh, who is a great mandolin player with a band called the Gibson Brothers, and he wrote this one especially for Lauren for her to record on her record All the Brighter, because he writes really good tunes, and she asked him to write her one for that, and this is what he came up with. It's called One Does What One Can.
Thank you.
you. Well, this is fun.
Yeah.
We're going to continue with a song. This is one, it's one of my favorite songs to sing. It's by the great Dolly Parton. And it's called Rockin' Years. I'll do everything I can to make you proud to be my man. I'll fulfill all your fantasies. I guess we're promising a lot, but for now it's all we got. I'll stand by you through these rocking years. Rocking chairs, rocking babies, rock a bye, rock of ages. Side by side, we'll be together always. And if you hold me tight when you love me, that's all I'll ask of you. I'll stand by you. Good tune writer, and we're gonna do an original of hers in this next medley. We're gonna start off with an old tune that we learned from the playing of Mr. Bruce Molsky. It's called Piney Woods, and then we'll go into Lauren's tune, House on Hadley.
Yeah, and I want to send this out to my parents, who I think are watching tonight. So if you are, hi, Mom and Dad. hi to everybody out there, actually. I think think we have a lot of people watching. Barbara Haas, Brittany's mom, maybe Steven, your dad. I think my boyfriend's watching. Hi, guys. But this, the tune that I wrote is called House on Hadley, which is a lake that I grew up on. In Maine.
Last night we were in Bellingham at the Green Frog Cafe Acoustic Tavern, we didn't have a banjo that belonged to us because it didn't quite make it over on the plane. Lauren came from Maine yesterday morning, and the banjo got stuck in Newark. But we had some amazing people help us out in finding banjos, and we actually ended up with two. Did you just move that away?
I did. Move it away. Okay. Yeah.
We ended up with two banjos, but both of them had really long straps because they're normally played by tall men. And so they sat like down here. It was a lot harder to play. And yeah, now this feels so little.
Am I really flat?
Yeah, I'm coming down. Thank you.
How are we doing?
Come on, little guy.
Okay. This is one of my favorite songs to sing. It was a old parlor song, just like kind of perfect for this setting, and it was popularized by the Carter family. I think it's one of my favorites to play, actually. it's a combination of original tunes. The first one Brittany and I wrote together many years ago, maybe like 5 or so years ago, a while ago. And we wrote it on Brittany's birthday one day in Boston. We were walking around the streets, and we decided we wanted to write a tune that night. And we were incredibly dorky about it. We're like, we kind of planned it all out before we started doing it. We're like, okay, we both play 5 strings. We want to play more there should be more tunes in C minor, because if our 5th string is a C string. So we wanted to write a tune in C minor, and we were into a lot of Swedish music at the time, and we wanted to understand weird time signatures, and we said, okay, let's write this tune in 3-2. And we should have 3 parts, and there's going to be a crazy 3rd part, which is like modulating up to D major, and I don't know. We planned the whole thing out, and this is what we came up with. And then we're going to, so you can see, it's called Great Grimpen Meyer, and then we're going to go into a tune of Brittany's that she wrote, a really cool jig that is also in C, and it recently named. And why don't you tell us what the name is?
Well, it's sort of relevant, because as Michael was telling you, this place is sort of like a named after his initials, and it's like a sound-alike sort of thing. And this tune is in the key of C, and and we're calling, it's so dorky. We're calling it Key of the Sea, but key, like, you know, the key that's like Q-U-A-Y, that kind of thing. And C-S-E-A. Well, actually, it came about because of a spoonerism that I misspoke one time. I was trying to say, this is in the key of C, and I said, this is in the C of key. So, that's how it happened.
Thank you.
tune we're going to do is kind of one of my favorite tunes of all time, especially to play with one fiddle and one banjo. It's pretty great for that setting. It's a tune called John Brown's Dream. Does anybody know that tune? You guys play that? Sweet. It's a fun one. It's got three parts. Features the banjo playing of Lauren Rioux on this fabulous instrument that we're so glad is still in one piece.
Yeah.
So.
Solo album, which is one of my all-time favorite albums in the world. I actually wore out my first copy. I played it so much. I didn't know you could really wear out a CD, but it's possible. So I had to get another copy. But I highly recommend that CD and that tune. Yeah. All right, this next one is a song that was written by one of my students, Issa Burke. Brittany and I met at fiddle camp. and we actually have some fiddle camp friends here tonight. And it's a magical place, fiddle camp, full of wonderful people and great tunes and happy times. And my student has grown up going to fiddle camps, and she wrote this one winter longing for the sunshine and the wonderful things, the wonderful time at fiddle camp. So this is called the Montville Song, after the Maine fiddle camp, which happens in Montville, Maine. Thank you.
Well, thank you guys so much. We're going to play one more tune and then take a bit of a break. And, yeah, we're having a really good time. How's everybody doing out there? This last tune we're going to do is one that I wrote while I was in college. And I wrote it for a little duo that I had with one of my awesome professors, this guy named Dan Trueman, who plays the Hardanger fiddle, which is a Norwegian version of the fiddle it's really, really cool. You should check them out on YouTube or something. But they have like carved scrolls up here, like in the shape of some kind of like dragon mythical monster, and they have all this beautiful inlay of pearl and stuff on the fingerboard and everything. And then they have these extra strings that run along beneath here, like in this crazy little tunnel that they have, and it goes through the bridge, and they vibrate sympathetically, so it's got this really crazy beautiful sound. And he and I play some stuff together and wrote a bunch of tunes together, and this is one of those. It's called Crisscross. Thank you. to the second set. We're going to do a little medley here of one tune and one song. And the tune is one called Grey Owl. It's a Canadian tune. And then from there, we're going to go into a song written by a really fabulous lady and a good friend of ours, Miss Aoife O'Donovan, who you may know from Crooked Still or from the Goat Rodeo or stuff like that. She's pretty amazing. And she wrote this next song, and it's called Red and White and Blue and Gold.
Wanna see your place, wanna take you in. baby, let's go. Baby, let's go. There's a southbound train pulling out at 9. We'll leave this jukebox joint behind. Come on, let's have one more. I don't wanna go. I'm not ready to go. I'm scared of the way that my heart gets sore. Wondering if you're
Christmas present a couple years ago. It's called The Berlin Savant. It's in her favorite key of E major. And it goes like this. Thank you.
we're gonna do just a couple of traditional old-timey tunes, which are always really fun. And these are just kind of two of our favorite tunes to play.
They're both a lot of favorite tunes. Aren't
yeah, that's true. I said. Yep.
That's how it goes.
I feel like sometimes I get in these ruts of saying the same word a lot, and tonight seems to be favorite. Sometimes it's amazing. Like, our friend who's so amazing wrote this amazing tune. It's really amazing.
But, this is so our favorite. It's really our favorite.
So, these tunes are normally in the key of D, but we've got our fiddles kind of detuned down to B, so we're going to play them in B for you, and they're called Julian Johnson and the Belle of Lexington. And I'd like to dedicate this set to our friends who have a really fabulous band that you guys should check out if you haven't heard yet. They're called The Onlys. I know they're playing at the Folklife Festival, right? In May. And they're really great, so this goes out to you guys.
Thank you.
guys heard of this really great band, the Bee Eaters? Some people? Well, if you haven't, you should check them out, or maybe they'll get a chance to play here, but they're a really fantastic, awesome, favorite band. One of the band members, actually Tristan Claridge, was the cellist in Crooked Still, the band that Brittany has been in for the past 3 or 4 years. So, and his sister, Tashina, is an amazing musician and wrote this beautiful tune, actually on Brittany's fiddle at a fiddle camp. And I fell in love with the melody, and she graciously allowed me to record it on my album. And on the album, Britt and I play it with a really cool cellist, Mike Block. She didn't title it, so we just call it Tashina's Tune. And here it is. Cheat sheet on this one. Shh. Thank you. So how many people are Irish here? Me.
That explains the green shoes.
Yeah. Well, thank you for spending St. Paddy's with us. Single Irish tune in our set. I guess I count as the Irish portion of the evening.
Yeah, three green things, that's enough for the both of us.
Playing out of tune. But that's not really true.
Thank you.
time with all of you guys. What's everybody doing tomorrow? We're getting up and getting on the ferry to Bainbridge Island, and we're going to play out there in the afternoon, which will be really nice, because sometimes you get into this sort of rut of sleeping in, driving, eating, soundchecking, eating, playing a gig, and then repeat, but so it's kind of cool to have an afternoon thing.
And a ferry ride.
Yeah, we like those. anyways, so if you feel like coming, that'd be fun.
We've been touring a lot lately, which has been really exciting for us. We were in Nashville last weekend, but prior to that, we toured the Northeast in New England for 2 weeks, and we got to ride a ferry on that tour too, because we went to Martha's Vineyard. So I think that we should try to do that every tour. Because that's one of my favorite things to do. Well, we would like to invite you to perform this one with us. If you wouldn't mind. Do you guys like to sing?
Yeah.
Say yes.
Okay. So you guys might already know this song, but for those of you that don't, we'll just go over it real quick. Like, I'll sing you the line and then sing it back to me. People watching on the internet, you must sing along too. Okay, so it starts out. Well, I ain't got no you. Sing that with me.
Well, I ain't got no you. No use for that red rocking chair. Ain't got no use for that red rocking chair. Got no sugar baby now.
Got no sugar baby now.
Got no sugar honey baby now.
Got no sugar honey baby now.
Yeah, let's do that whole thing together.
Well, I ain't got no use. No use for that red rocking chair. Got no sugar baby now. Got no sugar honey baby now.
Yeah, awesome.
You guys sound excellent. So we'll definitely come to Bainbridge tomorrow.
We'll sing that verse at the top and then again when we get to the end. And thanks again for coming, everybody. And a special thank you to Mr. Michael Connolly for having this awesome venue. It's so fabulous. And to everybody, yes. Everybody on the sound crew and the video crew and Jordan back there and Heather and all of you guys for coming. So thanks.
Okay.
Give it to your mama next payday. Give it to your mama next payday.
Cajun tune that we learned from Darol Anger. It's called the Old Carpenter's Waltz.